लिंक पे नहीं थे रखकर
देखो
स्टार्ट कर
स्टार्ट खुद
नहीं
रखेंगे, स्टार्ट करना है
लिंक हाँ
खुद पे तो।
माय प्रणाम्स टू ऑल आत्म ज्योतिस डिवाइन लाइट ऑफ द सेल्फ आई वेलकम ऑल द चिल्ड्रन एंड पेरेंट्स फॉर टुडेज सेशन फर्स्ट लेट अस डू नमस्कार Namaskara means God in my heart and God in your heart is one. We respect each other. Namaste. God in your heart and in my heart in the form of divine light, Atma Jyoti. We offer respect to each other. Let us offer respect to Guru by chanting mantra. First, I will chant, then you can repeat after that. Guru Brahma,
Guru
Vishnu,
Guru
Devo,
Maheshwaraha,
Guru Sakshat, Parabrahma,
Tasmai Shri,
Gurave Namaha. Dear children, today we are going to listen to the story of Bhakta Prahlada, a great devotee of Bhagavan Vishnu. A young child called Bhakta Prahlada and about his devotion to Bhagavan Vishnu. Is the story we'll focus today. Long, long back, there was a demon king, a terrible demon king. His name was Hiranyakashyapu. When we say demon king, you can think he is a terrorist, a terrible person. He wants more and more power. He wants to control more and more people and give trouble. He wanted to get large power. For that, he prayed to Brahmaji. He meditated on Brahmaji, the creator. To give him more power. He sat in meditation for many, many years. Then Brahmaji appeared in front of him. What do you want? Hiranyakashyapu said, I want deathlessness. Nobody should be able to kill me. So I should be death proof. Brahmaji said, that is not possible. Every living being who is born will have to die. Then Hiranyakashyapu said, okay, grant me a boon. No human being or animal. No human being or animal should be able to kill me. I should not be killed inside or outside. I should not be killed in morning or night. I should not be killed by any weapon. He thinks very smart. He is very, very smart. He is asking for a boon which is impossible. That means he cannot be killed by anybody or anything. Brahmaji says, okay. He, Hiranyakashipu, thinks he is smart. Let us see what happens to Hiranyakashipu. So now Hiranyakashipu has become very, very powerful. Nobody can kill him. So he goes and terrorizes everybody. Creates lot of terror. He terrorizes human beings. He terrorizes devatas. And starts controlling the entire world of human beings and devatas. Devatas are troubled. They see the suffering of human beings. When the terrorists are controlling the earth, human beings are suffering. So devatas go and pray to Bhagavan Vishnu. Bhagavan Vishnu, please protect us. Please protect the human beings. The terrorist Hiranyakashipu is creating a lot of problems for human beings. Please save human beings. Then Vishnu, Bhagavan Vishnu tells Narada. Narada is a devotee of Bhagavan Vishnu. Narada always thinks of God, Narayana. Narayana always remembers God. How does he remember? I'll chant. You can repeat after me. Okay, all children should chant and repeat after me. How does Narada remember Vishnu? Narayana.
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 Satya Narayana. Swami Narayana. Satya Narayana. Swami Narayana. 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 I hope all the children chanted the God's name, Narayana. So Narada, Vishnu tells Narada, go and teach to Hiranyakashipu's son the devotion to God. Okay. Hiranyakashipu's son is still in the womb of mother. Hiranyakashipu's son is not yet born. He is in the mother's womb. Hiranyakashipu's wife's name is Kayadu. Kayadu was pregnant. Go and teach the child of Hiranyakashipu who is yet to be born how to become devotee of Bhagavan, Bhakta of God. Bhakta of Bhagavan, devotee. Narada goes and teaches Kayadu, who is pregnant. And the child in the mother's womb starts listening to Narada. Narada is the guru, the teacher, who teaches the child Prahlada the God's name, chanting of God's name. Remembering God. The child Prahlada learns about God, remembering God in the mother's womb. The child is born. His name is Prahlada. The child's name is Prahlada. Prahlada means, Ahlada means joyful. Prahlada means always joyful, always smiling, always happy. Even though he is born in a demon's house, a terrorist house, the terrorist is always tensed up, terrorist always angry. Hiranyakashipu is always angry, always fighting with people, creating problem with people. The child Prahlada, born in Hiranyakashipu's house, is a divine child. He had a guru, master, Narada, who had taught him how to remember God's name. One who remembers God's name is always full of joy, happiness, like Prahlada, and is always peaceful. Prahlada, right from childhood, he remembers God's name. Whenever he plays with children, he remembers God's name. He was sent to school at the age of 5. When he was sent to the school at the age of 5, in those days, the school is called Gurukula. Hiranyakashipu had told gurus, the teacher in school, the children should not be taught about God at all. You should tell children that there is no God. Only Hiranyakashipu, the king, I am the God. Everybody should worship me. That's how the terrorists want to live. They want people to worship them, not God. Everybody should think of Hiranyakashipu as God. They should not think of Bhagavan Vishnu as God. The school teachers, poor fellows, they are afraid. Hiranyakashipu will give trouble to them if they teach about God. They didn't teach anything about God to Prahlada. But when the teachers are away, when the children are playing, Prahlada will get together all the children. Okay? He says to children, let us remember God's name. Let us think of God. Okay? We'll pray to God. And makes children chant God's name. Let us chant God's name together. That's what he tells the children. What do they chant? I'll chant. You can repeat after me. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hope all the children listening to this are chanting after me. Okay, let us chant God's name. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Krishna Krishna.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Hare Rama.
Rama Rama.
Rama Rama.
Hare Hare.
Hare Hare.
So by the time the school teachers come back, they see the Prahlada chanting God's name. Now they are terrified. They are scared because they know Hiranyakashipu, the terrorist king, will become angry and he will punish the teachers. They will run to Hiranyakashipu, to the king, and tell Hiranyakashipu, Maharaj, your son is chanting God's name. We didn't teach him. We didn't teach him. Please don't punish us. Please tell your son not to chant God's name. Hiranyakashipu is very, very angry. He calls his son, Prahlada. He tells Prahlada, there is no God. Okay? Don't believe in God. There is no God at all. I am the God. The demon king, the terrorist, is the God. You have to follow what I say. Prahlada says, there is God. I get joy in telling God's name. I want to sing God's name. When I sing God's name, I feel very happy. God's name gives a lot of happiness. I want to pray to God and sing God's name. Hiranyakashipu is very, very angry with Prahlada. he tells his servants, this boy is born to me. He is a son of a king Hiranyakashipu. I don't like the behavior of this boy. In my kingdom, nobody should chant God's name. Take this boy and throw from the mountain top. The servants of Hiranyakashipu, the terrorist king, they take him to the top of the mountain. And a very big mountain, and throw the boy from the top of the mountain. Is Prahlada afraid? Prahlada is not afraid. He just closes his eyes and chants God's name. I'll chant and you can repeat after me. Om Namo Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
So when he chants God's name, God comes running from Vaikuntha. Bhagavan Vishnu comes running from Vaikuntha. Vasudeva means Bhagavan Vishnu is everywhere. Vasati iti Vasudeva. He is everywhere. Bhagavan Vishnu comes running and he catches the child who is falling from the top of the mountain and lands him softly on the ground. Not a single hurt for Prahlada. Prahlada. Hiranyakashipu is now very angry. He is not killed after throwing from the mountain. He says, tie the child to the rope and throw him into ocean. Prahlada is not afraid at all. The servants of Hiranyakashipu throw Prahlada into the ocean. Then Prahlada chants, Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
A 6-year-old child simply praying to Bhagavan Vishnu, Vasudeva. Vasudeva comes running. He comes in the form of a fish, lifts Prahlada and lands him on the shore. Nothing happens to Prahlada. Hiranyakashipu is terribly angry. Now he says, throw Prahlada into fire. Throw Prahlada into the fire. Then Hiranyakashipu's sister is there. Her name is Holika. She catches hold of fire, Prahlada, and puts him into burning fire, big fire. Is Prahlada afraid? No. Prahlada is smiling because he knows God protects, Bhagavan Vishnu protects. He starts chanting, Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
Immediately the fire becomes cold. Fire can't touch Prahlada. Instead of that, the Holika, the king's, the Hiranyakashipu's sister gets burnt. Bhagavan Vishnu converts the fire into cold fire for Prahlada. Prahlada is very happy. He is singing God's name. He is very happy. Hiranyakashipu is very, very angry now. Terribly angry. He tells, throw the child under the feet of a big elephant. There is a big elephant. So Prahlada was brought and thrown in front of the elephant. So that elephant will crush the head of Prahlada with his feet. Is Prahlada afraid? Prahlada is not afraid. Prahlada knows Bhagavan Vishnu will come and protect him. He smiles and he says, chants, Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate.
Bhagavate.
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
The elephant comes to Prahlada. Instead of crushing Prahlada, it does namaskara. It bows down to Prahlada. And it lifts Prahlada and keeps on his back. So every people, all the people standing there, they start clapping with the six-year-old child. He cannot be killed at all. No terrorist can defeat the devotee of Bhagavan, Vishnu. So then Hiranyakashipu is very, very angry with Prahlada. He brings him to the palace. He doesn't understand how this child cannot be killed. How this child is protected. How Bhagavan, God, is protecting child Prahlada. He doesn't understand. He says, where is your Vishnu? Where is your Vasudeva? So Prahlada says, Bhagavan Vishnu is everywhere. Bhagavan Vishnu is in my heart. That's why when I say Vasudeva, Vishnu, Bhagavan in my heart, he starts smiling and he puts me. Nothing happens to me. Fire cannot burn me. Elephant cannot crush me. The ocean cannot destroy me. From mountain, even if I fall, Bhagavan Vishnu will protect me. He is everywhere. Hiranyakashipu is very, very, very angry. He says, is your Bhagavan Vishnu everywhere? Prahlada says, yes. Is he in this pillar? In this pillar he is there? Prahlada says, yes. Prahlada, Bhagavan Vishnu is there in sky, water, fire, wind, earth. He is in the building, he is in the human beings, he is in the animal, he is in the pillar also. Bhagavan Vishnu is there in the pillar also. God is there everywhere. He is in me. He is in you. Hiranyakashipu is very angry. Show me where is Vishnu. I will kill him. I want to kill Vishnu. And he breaks open that pillar. Dhada! Dhamma! The big pillar in the palace is broken by Hiranyakashipu. Prahlada is just watching his father. And he is chanting, Om Namo,
Om Namo
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya,
Vasudevaya.
Om Namo,
Om
Bhagavate,
Bhagavate
Vasudevaya.
Vasudevaya.
Now Bhagavan Vishnu comes from the pillar. How does he come? He comes as Narasimha, the terrible form. Narasimha means, Nara means human being. Simha means lion. Lion face and human body. Why did he come? He came to protect Prahlada. Bhagavan doesn't like his devotees getting disturbed. He wants to protect his devotees at any point of time. Prahlada is devotee of Vishnu. God protects when you chant his. Hiranyakashipu was harassing Prahlada. Bhagavan Vishnu came in the terrible form of Narasimha. Nara means human, Simha means lion. Lion head and human body. Why did he come as lion head and human body? Hiranyakashipu, remember, he had taken a boon. Neither human nor animal can kill. He thought he is smart. But Bhagavan Vishnu is smarter. He is the smartest. He is the most intelligent. Instead of sending a human being or animal, he comes as human plus animal. Lion plus man. Lion man. Very powerful. And he roars. Hearing the roar, Hiranyakashipu is terrified. Bhagavan gets angry because his devotees are harassed. When the people are troubled, Bhagavan shouts, roars. The terrorist Hiranyakashipu starts trembling. Then Narasimha picks him up. and takes him to the near the door. He sits on the doorstep. Then with his nails, he cuts open the stomach of Hiranyakashipu. Remember the bone of Hiranyakashipu had asked, I should not be killed inside or outside. Bhagavan, God is smarter than the terrorist, smarter than the demon. Bhagavan knows how to not to kill inside or outside. He kills him in the doorstep, which is neither inside nor outside. Then Hiranyakashipu had asked one more boon. What is that? He should not be killed by any weapon. Narasimha does not use any weapon. He just uses his fingernails, nails of the lion, and cuts open the stomach of Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu thought he is smart. He can defeat Bhagavan. He can defeat God. God cannot be defeated. God is super intelligence. Then Hiranyakashipu had asked, I should not be killed in the morning or even night. Hiranyakashipu was killed in the twilight. Neither morning nor night. See, the terrorists think they are very smart. Okay? The demon king thinks he is smart. But God, Bhagavan is much, 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 much smarter than him. And Hiranyakashipu was killed. Then Prahlada comes and does namaskara to Hiranyakashipu, Bhagavan Vishnu, Bhagavan Narasimha. He chants, Namo Namo,
Namo Namo,
Narasimhaya,
Narasimhaya,
Namo Namo,
Namo Namo,
Narasimhaya,
Narasimhaya,
Namo Namo,
Namo Namo,
Narasimhaya,
Narasimhaya.
Narasimha is pleased by the devotion of Prahlada. He takes the beautiful form of Bhagavan Vishnu. Now he is not a terrible form. Terrible form was there to scare the demons, scare the terrorists. He takes the beautiful form of Bhagavan Vishnu. How is Bhagavan Vishnu? He is beautiful, blue form, blue body, radiating light with four hands, Shankha, Chakra, Gada, Padma. In one hand, he has a shankha, the conch. Another hand, he has chakra, the disc. Another hand, he has gada, mace. And another hand, he has lotus. And Bhagavan Vishnu and Mahalakshmi, wife of Bhagavan Vishnu, appear in front of Bhakta Prahlada. And ask Prahlada, I am pleased with your devotion. I'll give a boon to you. Ask whatever boon you want. Prahlada says, Bhagavan, I don't want any boon. See, the 6-year-old child, he says, I don't want any boon. I don't want any gift. All that I want is, I want to remember the name of Bhagavan all the time. I want to chant God's name all the time. Till I am alive, I want to chant God's name. I want to chant Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya, till I am alive. I want always God's name, nothing else. I want you only. Bhagavan Vishnu and Mahalakshmi is so pleased by the devotion of the child. Bhagavan Vishnu says, Tathastu. You will always remember my name. Then he says, I will give one more boon. One more boon. Take it. Then Prahlada says, Oh Bhagavan, my father has done a lot of mistakes in his life. He created a lot of trouble for people. He harassed people. He was a terrorist. Please forgive him. Okay. That's all I want. So Hiran, Bhagavan Vishnu forgives Hiranyakashipu. Hiranyakashipu, instead of going to the hell, all the people who create trouble for others, they will go to hell after death. His sin is forgiven. His suffering in the hell is reduced because of boon Prahlada had asked. So after that, Prahlada lives long and he rules the kingdom and he brings peace to the people and people are very happy. His father Hiranyakashipu had terrorized people. Prahlada takes care of people. We'll get devotion in God. We have to learn the divine qualities of Prahlada. Prahlada means always joyful, always happy, always wishing well for the people, always taking care of the society, doing service to the society, always happy, and always thinking of God. So let us pray to Bhagavan Vishnu to give us, bless us of the divine qualities of Prahlada. Bless us so that we can remember God's name all the time. We don't forget God's name anytime. We need to pray to Vishnu, please protect us in all difficulties. First, protect us. Om Namo Bhagavate Vasudevaya. We'll close the session today. Let us bring qualities of Prahlada in our life. Namaste. Let us chant. Asato ma.
Asato ma.
Sadgamaya.
Sadgamaya.
Tamaso ma.
Tamaso ma.
Jyotirgamaya.
Jyotirgamaya.
Mrityorma.
Mrityorma.
Amritam gamaya.
Amritam gamaya.
Om.
Om.
Shanti.
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 Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Lokaha samastaha.
Lokaha samastaha.
Sukhino bhavantu.
Sukhino bhavantu.
May all living beings be happy, peaceful. May Bhagavan Vishnu bless us all. Namaste.